Ford runs Walmart's last mile delivery operations.
Customers expect us to save them money. They need us to save them time. And when it comes to saving time, what better way to do it than via drone?
Zipline is part of a growing list of companies looking to make commercial drone delivery more accessible. Each zip returns to home base and hooks itself to this suspension cable.
Normal recovery, Zipline 963.
Where it awaits its next mission. Errol Barnett, CBS News.
So what happens if that package gets stuck in the tree? Who's going up the tree to get it? In South Centerville, the Kroger store on State Route 48 is a pilot site for Kroger's drone delivery program. Kroger started the program in July when we first covered it and delivered within a mile of the store. Then earlier this month, Kroger expanded that radius to 2 miles of the store. The deliveries are limited to 5 pounds, but that still includes things that are fragile or breakable. Kroger said it delivers all orders within an hour. It has not talked about plans to expand the delivery service to its other stores.
Now, your Storm Center 7 forecast with Chief Meteorologist McCall Brightaggs.
And, of course, the weather experts on the set tonight have said, what happens if it's windy?
Yeah, if it's windy.
We saw plenty of wind today.
Yeah, we did. I don't know if that little zip line drone thingy was going to be able to make it from point A to point B. And the wind, it was making it feel so much colder out there.
I was going to say cold, not chilly. Cold.
Yeah, cold, cold. And that's because the temperatures were down in the upper 30s to low 40s. You had that wind chill factor, made it feel like the 30s no matter what across the area. And with cold air in place, that actually allowed the chance for some light snow showers to pass through the northern Miami Valley earlier this evening. And I'm going to talk more about when we might see more of some snowflakes and even some rain in the forecast as we walk you through the next couple of minutes here. Now let's talk about those temperatures that we have in the Miami Valley and still do right now. We are looking at numbers across the area in the upper 30s to low 40s. You can see Dayton currently sitting at about 40 degrees. We have 36 for you in Bellefontaine, 37 for you out in Wilmington. We're at about 37 in Greenville as well. What I'm tracking as we look ahead for the next few days, we're going to dry out for tonight. Rain does return for the middle of the week. I see Wednesday going to be a pretty soggy afternoon for us. It's brief, but still that chance for rain is there. But then as we get into Thursday and Friday, we're going to dry out and we have some warmer weather that's going to be moving back in. Now let's talk about that precipitation that we've been dealing with. You can see on Live Doppler 7 radar and our satellite imagery that we have a little bit of that snowfall activity skimming through the far northeastern part of our viewing area. I was checking some ODOT cameras up in portions of Auglaize County and Logan County. I didn't see any coating of snow there, so if you did pick up a trace amount of snowfall and you snapped a picture, send it to me on my social media accounts or over on my email account as well. It was all the way just northeast of the Miami Valley that I saw a little bit of some light coating of snow just outside of our viewing area. Get in close here and you can see in Logan County and in Champaign County there is a little bit of that light snowfall, a few flurries or maybe an enhanced snow shower pushing through Bellefontaine, through West Liberty, down into Urbana, up and down US 68. For the most part, no problems expected from this because our road temperatures themselves are above freezing. So we're not going to see anything sticking or causing any issues if you're traveling tonight. Here is a look in Urbana, and you can see the roads look just fine, and we're seeing the green grass there. So again, nothing accumulating from any of that light flurry or snow shower activity coming through. Futurecast shows, as we move through the rest of tonight, we are going to watch that pulling away to our east. We actually have a good amount of clearing by tomorrow morning. So there's 7 a.m. for you. We'll have plenty of sunshine throughout much of the day, just a few passing clouds. There's 5 p.m. tomorrow afternoon, still a nice finish with that sunshine. Clouds move back in on Wednesday, and then for Wednesday afternoon, once we get past midday, we'll have a couple of sprinkles or a light shower that will move on by. Not a lot in the way of precipitation there, but still it's going to bring a bit of an impact. Our 7-day outlook does show that we have a cool day for you on tomorrow for Tuesday, 48 degrees for your high. Wednesday, we'll have a little bit of that light shower activity come through. We get to about 48 degrees once again. Milder on Thursday. It becomes rather windy for us across the area, but those winds push those temperatures well into the upper 50s, and we'll stay mild on Friday as well. Then as we head into the weekend, dry Saturday, but I'm keeping a close eye on Sunday's forecast. as it looks as though we'll get some rain showers that come in that may mix with a few snowflakes for the afternoon and evening, and perhaps we'll end as a few flurries or a snow shower on Monday with temperatures dropping back to highs in the 30s. James?
All right, McCall. There are those thieves who will steal packages right off your front porch. Consumer analysts said delivery services will drop off more than $60 billion worth of holiday packages this season. A new survey from CNET found almost 125 million Americans will leave those packages unattended for at least 3 hours. The survey also found about one-third of people do not have a plan to keep their gifts safe from thieves. This was once the Wright Brothers' first bicycle shop. Now the city of Dayton says it's okay to tear the place down. But a group of preservationists told us they would rather see the city do something different with the property. So what is that plan? We'll be right back.